Hi everyone, good evening. Today I have brought some interesting topic for you all to discuss, and that is drama. So the same topic I have been discussing with my sir, Dr. Essen Singh, for the past 2 days. So first of all, we must understand from where did drama originate. Drama originated from poetry. Now, what is a drama? Drama is an artistic form which is staged in a theater, radio, television, etc. It consists of characters, dialogues, narrative techniques, theme, plot, etc. So all this together comprise a drama. Now let us compare the Eastern concept and Western concept in the analysis of drama. So there is one thing which is similar about the Western and Eastern concept in analyzing the drama, and that is that they were religious. In case of Western concept, dramas were played in churches during Sunday evenings, either before the prayer or after that. And in case of Eastern concept, drama was not as such discriminated or divided, but they were studied in the form of human emotions. So this was done by Bharat Muni, who was the author of Natyashastra. He was the first one to study drama in by connecting it with human emotions. But in case of Western concept, drama was discriminated or divided on the basis of two things, that is tragedy and comedy. So this was done by Aristotle. Both Bharat Muni and Aristotle believed that drama is a mode of imitation. But there was one thing in which they were different in their opinions. Bharat Muni always studied drama in the form of human emotions. That is, he studied drama through Navarasas. So he always connected human emotions to drama. But in case of Aristotle, he felt that action was very much important in a drama. He even said that if a hero is not present in a tragedy, that tragedy would still go on, but action is very much important in a tragedy. This is according to the Western concept. But in case of Eastern concept, it is the other way around. In case of Eastern concept, a hero is must for a tragedy. That is, a tragedy cannot exist without a hero. So this is the basic difference between Eastern concept and Western concept. So now let us understand the Western concept and how they have divided the drama. So according to the Western concept, they have divided drama into tragedy and comedy. So now let us understand what is a comedy. Comedy means a storyline having a happy ending. So that is what you call as comedy. So it basically consists of fun, laughter, irony, sarcasm, humor, farce, etc. But farce can be called as a part of comedy. It is an exaggeration of events, and the incidents that has been shown in a farce is completely useless. But they just exaggerate those events and create in the spectators extreme laughter. That is basically the use of farce. And Aristotle has said that in a farce or in a comedy, the characters or the person acting in a comedy cannot be called a hero. but they are called as comic characters. This is one of the most important thing that is to be noticed in a comedy. Next is tragedy. So tragedy means a storyline having a sad ending. That is what you call by tragedy. So it is serious, complete, and it is a mode of imitation, all these things. And action is there, etc. So now we must understand what is a good tragedy and what is a tragedy. So in order to differentiate between a good tragedy and a tragedy, one must follow the certain guidelines that has been provided by Aristotle. So he has given us 3 to 4 guidelines in order to understand what is a good tragedy. So in a good tragedy, the very first thing is that there would be a tragic hero. So the tragic hero, he would be from a royal family or from a high position, or he would be from high birth, and it would also indicate the downfall of that tragic hero. So that downfall will happen from a high position to a low position. And this when this downfall happens, it should happen mainly due to the mistake of the own tragic hero. That is, the downfall of the tragic hero will happen due to his own mistake or because of his own fault. So if all these conditions satisfy, then it becomes a good tragedy. But if a person is having a downfall just because of his destiny or fate, then it cannot be called a good tragedy. But it can be a form of tragedy, but it is not at all a good tragedy. So let us analyze this with the help of an example. So for example, a dog. There is a dog which is standing at the top of the hill. So suddenly the dog falls from the top of the hill. So when the dog falls from the top of the hill, we can call it a tragedy, but it is not a good tragedy because it was not the dog's fault or the dog's mistake, but it was destiny or fate which led the dog to fall from the top of the hill. Now I hope you all must have understood what is a tragedy and what is a good tragedy. So now we will get on to the Middle Age. So Shakespeare, as you all know, Shakespeare is a Middle Age writer. So he has been writing in the Middle Ages, that is during the Romantic period, that is 18th, 19th century. He was very much famous for. So before the writings, before Shakespeare wrote, there were other English authors who wrote in English. So these authors, they were basically called as university wits. So university wits means they are a group of professors from the University of Oxford and Cambridge. There are many such authors like Christopher Marlowe and others. So one such example is Christopher Marlowe. So all these authors who wrote before Shakespeare, that is, they are the old English authors I am talking about. So all those authors who wrote before Shakespeare, they followed certain strict guidelines in order to write a drama. So if an author is trying to write a tragedy, he would completely write the story which would be a tragedy. That is, he'll write the pure form of tragedy or a classical tragedy. It is the same for comedy. If he wished to write comedy, he would write the pure form of comedy or you can call it as a classical comedy. As I said, for a good tragedy, you need the certain guidelines as told by Aristotle. That is, the first thing is that the tragic hero, he must be from a high family or from a high birth or from a royal family. and his downfall should be from a high position to a low position, and that too, that downfall should happen due to his own inherent characteristic traits, or because or otherwise you can say his own mistakes, or because of his own flaws and faults. So that would only satisfy the conditions for a good tragedy. So if that is, authors before Shakespeare, they basically wrote good tragedies. They did not mix up things. So there were certain limitations in writing drama before Shakespeare. So when Shakespeare came, he tried to break out all these limitations and remove those limitations, and he made drama very much flexible by combining and mixing up all those things. For example, you can say he mixed up tragedy and comedy, which formed into tragic comedy. For example, Merchant of Venice. Merchant of Venice is a very good example for tragic comedy that Shakespeare has wrote. There are a lot many other examples. This is what I actually wanted to share with you all, and thank you for listening to me. Thank you so much.